Hey everyone, my name is Greg and I'm with the developer advocacy team here at Zendesk. Today's tutorial, we're going to show you how to set up a server-side app in your Zendesk instance. It's going to be perfect for someone who hasn't done this before, not really sure where to start. This will give you all the basics that you need to get up and running with a server-side app in your Zendesk instance. Let's get started. All right, so if you're going to be following along using glitch.com, go over to glitch.com. And when it loads up, click on New Project and then select Find More. Reason we're doing this is because the Hello website and all that, they contain just a bunch of stuff that we don't need. And since this is going to be the most basic app ever, we're just deleting things, you might as well just go with the basic app. So I'm just going to start by deleting script.js. And style.css, because this project will have no style. All right, I'm also going to delete all the contents of the index.html and then replace it with my own HTML boilerplate that I use for Zendesk apps. You can use what was there. Most important part is that you import the XAF SDK with this script. And we also need to make sure that we're initializing the client. So this is going to give us some positive affirmations. When you're having a bad day, you click a little button in the ticket sidebar and it puts a comment in the agent workspace comment field. It's great. Go ahead and create a script to do that. All right, so we'll call this send vibe. And the method that we're going to use to do that is, let's see, the append comment append text method in XAF. So we'll start with comment.append text. There are a couple other methods available if you want to use markdown or HTML. And we're going to have it tell us that we're just super with an exclamation point. And now we'll go down here to the button. We'll say send vibe. Okay, then we'll say click me. Positive affirmation. So now that we have the server side app set up, let's go ahead and create the Zendesk app with CCLI. Okay, so open up your favorite terminal window. If you're new to making Zendesk apps, if you're new to CCLI, I'll have a link in the description. So let's go ahead, we'll create a directory called server side app. My name is Greg. Your name might be something different. My very real email address. No need to put a website in there, but you can if you'd like. I don't know. We'll call this Zendesk Tutorial Server Side App. All right, great. So what that'll do is create a folder for us. And what we want to do is open up the manifest.json. So go ahead and open up whatever code editor you like. We've got our manifest.json here, and the area that we're going to be targeting is the URL. So let's go back to Glitch and grab the URL. To do that, we'll click share, and then next to the live site option, click that link. And then we'll go back over to Visual Studio Code and take the asset slash iframe.html, replace it with the URL, and save that. So go back to our terminal window, and we'll start first by making sure that you're logged in. If you haven't yet logged in, if you don't have a profile set up in CCLI, make sure you're logged in. So you'll do that with this command here, and it will prompt you to enter your subdomain, and then your email and your password. My stuff's already entered, so I'm just entering nonsense data there. It's gonna say it failed for me. Don't worry, it won't fail for you. So we'll run CCLI app server here. And if this is your first time developing with Zendesk, the way that you'll access the local server is by appending this CCLI underscore apt equals true to the end of your URL in the Zendesk account. We'll go here to the Z3N developer advocacy instance. So right now, you'll see in our app sidebar, all we have is the REPL app. What we're going to do now, though, is we're going to append that ZCLI underscore apps equals true to the end of our URL, hit return. And what that's going to do is it's going to load only the app that we are developing locally. And so now we see that our positive affirmation app here is loaded. If we hit click me, we should see, oh yeah, look at that. I'm super. And the more times you click it, the more true it becomes. And that's it. You know, we got a server-side app up and running. Now we only have this tested locally. I'll show you next how to upload this to your Zendesk instance. It just really shows you how easy it is to get the server-side app up and running. So let's go back over to terminal now.
All right.
And we'll close the server down. And let's go ahead and upload this to our Zendesk instance. And actually, I just realized before when I told you to log in, you didn't actually need to log in yet. You need to be logged in now. It's not necessary to log in when using ZCLI app server. So, but it is for this next part, which is ZCLI apps create. What this will do is validate the app, package it up, and then upload it to the Zendesk instance that you're logged into. So I'll just go ahead and do that. Uploading, deploying, and successfully installed. Hooray. So now we'll go back over to our instance, and then we will remove ZCLI apps true. And now we should see two apps here. We have our REPL app over here, and then we have successfully uploaded our positive affirmation app, and there it goes. So that's it. This was a basic tutorial here today. Just wanted to show you how easy it was to get this up and going. In the future, we'll dive into some more advanced topics, like secure settings. And if you have any questions, drop them in the comments below. Thanks. Have a great day.